All right, we are back here at the charity auction at the University of Phoenix Stadium. We're here with legendary John Morey. Thank you, John, for volunteering your time today and
My pleasure. Coming down and putting a couple pictures
in the auction. How many pictures do you have this year?
I have three this time.
You have three pieces of art at the auction. So specifically, we pulled this one out. It kind of speaks to me being from Arizona, and I've actually gone here with you, but no one out there knows where it is. So why don't you tell me, where's the picture taken at?
Well, this is the Vermilion Cliffs National Monument. It's on the northern Arizona, southern Utah border. Only 20 people per day in the world are allowed to get in here through a permit. This place is specifically known as the Wave. And what it is just, essentially, it's eons and eons of sandstone and sand dunes that have just turned into petrified. And they have these magical waves that just, lines run forever, light is crazy, it bounces everywhere. It's really kind of mystical. It's special that so few people in the world can go in there, and luckily I've been good enough to get in there and take Nick along as well, and this is a special image to me.
One of the interesting things I noticed when we went there is most of the people that go here aren't even photographers. They're just hikers that come from Europe, and they hike in, they sit there for 2 minutes, and then they're like, all right, let's keep going.
Yeah, that's the beauty of it.
And that's just weird.
People just love, you know, wilderness, and that's what wilderness is all about, is these pristine areas that no one else can get into except for a few people who try, you know, to really, you know, people who appreciate it.
Definitely. The other thing that blew me away about this, from all the pictures you see of it, it looks ginormous.
Yeah.
And you get there, and you're like... We're here? It looks like a little skateboarding like half pipe when you get there. You're like, wow, it just doesn't, it looks so big, and especially printed this awesome here from Vivix. It just looks ginormous.
Sure.
But did that blow you away the first time you were there?
I think we recall walking through there the first time together, and it's like, wow, I expected this to be a little bit bigger.
Yeah.
But then, you know, most photographers, in order to pull the grandness of this landscape in, will use a wide angle lens. And so the area usually looks grander than maybe it is. This one actually, though, is shot to be in the perspective of the human eye, roughly 50 millimeters. So if you were standing here right now, this really would be roughly what you're seeing.
Like a real delight.
Yeah.
I love that you got clouds in there, too. I know we're always struggling with that. When we went out last time with Daniel, who we interviewed before this, we had gotten clouds, but there was no clouds on the whole hike out. And we're going, man, just give us a cloud.
Right.
And this tiny little cloud came into the sky, and I was kind of joking, like, look, we're getting mocked now. The universe is mocking us. And then it just exploded. And I was like, oh, there's our cloud.
If only you waited a little longer.
Yeah, exactly. No,
well,
no, we got the picture.
It became
a cloud that was like awesome. So we got mocked that time, the stars. So there was no clouds. There was clouds. There weren't clouds during the day, but then at night when we want to take star pictures, all that.
Well, you know, what's interesting, it reminds me of a story, because the person who invited me along on this trip, he and his other friends, they were photographers, but it was cloudy all day, and there was no real good light and no good sky, and they were convinced that it was just not worth staying till sunset. And I kept watching the sky for hours and hours, and I really believed that something was going to happen towards that late afternoon, and they didn't have the patience to wait, and they moved on.
Really?
And they left me behind, because they knew I have got two GPS, and I know how to get out of here, even in the middle of the night, and I've done that a few times. And I was glad I stayed, because really the light started to open up. And,
nice.
And you know, that's what I love about photography. It's such a lesson in patience.
It is, and same thing with that. We could have woke up that morning and said, oh, there's no clouds, forget it, we're not going. But we went out, and we huffed it out there, and we were, you know, just given all these clouds. It was amazing. So tell me about the water in here. I know when I was there with you, there was snow on the left side and everything. So was it raining before?
Well, our first time in there was in February, and there was lots of snow remnants from about a week or so before. And if you went up there right now, you'd probably find a lot of snow remnants like that. I actually was in here in November, and this is a surprise. I didn't expect to find any water. But what's interesting is every time I go here, the landscape is always different. And so my experience is always different. That's why I never get tired of it. You know, what we saw when we were there together with the snow and what we saw was different than the next time I was there versus the next time versus this fourth time I was here. And so every time, you know, I have a new reflection upon myself and the environment that I'm in here. And that's why the nature of this is the mind's reflective beauty of nature, is because really it's such a primeval picture, and the reflection upon myself is always primeval when I'm here. You know, I really get to see the best parts of myself and why I love this area.
So one of the other things too, I hear a lot of photographers ask, oh, are these over edited? Are these oversaturated? Are these? And this is what it really looks like. I've been there. I have pictures of that. The one over there behind the camera, actually, someone's like, oh, they edited that and put that reflection in that picture. I'm like, no, they didn't. And I showed them five pictures in my cell phone that's actually a reflection. So it's kind of funny. There's this common perception that everything's edited in Photoshop.
Well, it's keyword Photoshop, and people don't, you know, they'll say that rather loosely, you know.
Yep.
It's the truth, you know. Every digital image, to some degree, needs a minor bit of processing, whether it's, you know, a slight bit of sharpening or a slight bit of contrast or a slight bit of shadow, because truly, while the sensor of the camera is wonderfully detailed, it doesn't see like the human eye sees.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, and so now we have to bring our idea of what we saw back into that picture. And maybe there is some artisticness in the editing.
And there
is,
but
the idea is to keep it real, you know, so that people can just feel like they can walk right in and start stepping through that water. And that's only 2 inches of water, so it's okay. You can go in there.
Sure. Sure. So this is a real-to-life shot. If you were to hike out there and get one of those 20 permits, you could see this too. Yeah. And you don't need a camera. We already captured it for you. And on that note, it's number 253. You could bid on it. Value is $500 on this. So it's framed, as you see, it's a $500 value, but you can buy it now for that and take it home from the Home and Garden Show, or you could start bidding at, it's $20, but I'm sure this has bids on it.
Well, I know the bid history on this, and I can tell you right now, this is ridiculously right now, going home to someone for $70, unless someone else gets involved right now. I'm sorry, but you cannot buy the framing material and the double matting, nor the printing service, not even close for that.
No, just the material, not actually building the frame.
You know, we don't care. What we get is what we get, but gosh darn it, we sure would like to see a lot more go for this because it really is worth it. And so we'd like you to bid 70 or 80, or honestly, you don't limp in with a minor bid either. If you really see value, you see something you like here, honor its value. You know, give it something respectable, but something that if you win, you can still go home at the end of the day and say, I got a deal. And you know what, Down syndrome wins, you win. Everybody wins, and it's tax deductible, by the way.
So all that money is going to Down Syndrome Network. It's for opportunities and educational programs for kids out there that are affected by Down syndrome and their families. So please bid and bid often, and thank you very much again
for
volunteering down
here. It's my pleasure, always.
And taking some great pictures
really,
and keeping us interested.
Yeah.
So we'll see you soon.
All right, cheers.